Now Sorrento has been locked away. There's Wyndham Special going in now. Very open race. We're going to be repeating that line a few times today. Some wonderful racing coming up. Flying Spice is set. Serious Drink has joined them. Shelley's Magic comes in. Two to go in. And thanks to Rod, who joins us now for the first on the card. Carbrasel favourite ahead of Wyndham Special, Sorrento and Flying Spice in a race of a lot of hopes. Love's Choice moved in, completed the line, and they're set to go for the first on the card. All clear and they're away. Nova Claus dawdled out of the gates on the inside, and Perito was one of the first out. Ali Jacto, Wyndham Special got out quickly. So did Lucola, Be My Princess. Flying Spice is up there with Mrs. Bentley wider out, and Love's Choice is on the improve. As they settle fully into stride now, and going to the lead is Wyndham Special. Wyndham Special by three quarters to Love's Choice, one to Lucola Perito. Serious Drink booting around the outside, and then Be My Princess. A length to Camus running about sixth or seventh, three and four wide. Ali Jacto behind them on the rail, followed by Flying Spice, Mrs. Bentley, our Riesling. One Nova Claus, she's being trailed then by Carbrasel, who's in the centre, and over on the outside, Silvana. Back to the tail end of the field, Shelley's Magic on the inside of Sorrento. Serious Drink booted around the outside for Jim Cassidy, and at the 600, led by a length to Wyndham Special, a half to Love's Choice, one Perito, Lucola, Be My Princess, wider out. Three quarters of a length to Camus has been four wide the whole way. Then Mrs. Bentley, Ali Jacto, our Riesling, Sorrento coming wide. Carbrasel going for runs between horses as they corner. Next is Silvana around the turn now, and Serious Drink in front. Wyndham Special out to tackle. Running on is Camus despite a hard run, and then Perito, Lucola. Carbrasel is down the outside. Serious Drink in front of Camus, and Wyndham Special 100 to go. Serious Drink in front for the pumper, out by a length and a half. They're not making ground, and Serious Drink takes out the first, a length and a half to Camus second, Wyndham Special third, and Carbrasel ran on for fourth from Ali Jacto, Perito, and then came Nova Claus, Shelley's Magic, followed by Flying Spice, Silvana, Sorrento out wider. Back behind these to finish was our Riesling, and she was trailed over the line by Mrs. Bentley. Love's Choice, Lucola, Be My Princess is one of the last to greet the judge. Serious Drink has taken out the first on the card to pay 12.80 and 3.80. Drew the one from the outside, taken to the front a long way from home by Cassidy, and she kept on running. Number 16 wins the first. Serious Drink, Jim Cassidy. Second placing goes to number 9, KMS Scott Seamer. Well, it was never closer than 3 and 4 wide the whole way. And third in the event to number 5, Wyndham Special, who had the cosy run under Patrick Payne. Numbers in the first event, the Jack Godby plate 16, 9 and 5. Fourth home in the race, number 15, Carbrasel. And the official fifth was number 12, Ali Jacto. And the time, 124.17. 124.17. Serious Drink take.
Earlier this year, launched him into the juvenile spotlight with True Jewels winning in the Blue Diamond. So we'll hear from him very soon about his very strong book of rides. Of course, yesterday he rode Viscount to that marvellous George Main Stakes when he dethroned Shogun Lodge, the outstanding older horse with that great pull in the weights. Now, Hawkesbury, we're looking forward to see the debut of these open-topped barriers not too far away. That is the scene. The horses will shortly be called forward, and Kieran McAvoy will shortly be with us too. So at Hawkesbury, we're getting within a couple of minutes of start time for this race. In just a moment, we'll be linking up with Alf Matthews, and Alf will have Kieran McAvoy. Now, the market at Hawkesbury, there's a look at the barriers, the Panthers barriers, and we've got around 90 seconds of betting time. Alf, you'll have a chance to kick things off with Kieran McAvoy, yesterday's Group 1 winning star.
Yes, we certainly have. Kieran, well done.
On this historic day at Hawkesbury, the open barriers, they look magnificent. Track in great order, good card, 9 races set to go. Alexander's Joy's been heavily backed, short price favoured, into the red on track. Only one they want. Chesapeake Bay standing well. Or at least Chesapeake Warrior, I should say. They're off. Whip around wide out and ear tear away very quickly. Showing speed is Proud Harvest after the start, or Reef the Harvest going up to be second. Alexander's Joy not far away from Primo Power. Credit-wise outside of it. Chesapeake Warrior getting back. And Codesti after a moderate start, the last one. Ear tear in front of Reap the Harvest. Alexander's Joy booting up on the fence and has the rail too, is going to use it. Credit-wise fourth, whip around it. Two links, Primo Power, Codesti and Chesapeake Warrior. before the bend. Iatir in front. Alexander's Joy railing throughs three quarters back. Reap the Harvest, the outside of it, a length away credit-wise under the bat from Whip Around. Primo Power, Codesti and Chesapeake Warrior. Iatir in front, leading the way. Alexander's Joy's flat at the moment on the fence, trying to pick up Iatir, who shot away. He's two lengths in front of Alexander's Joy. Whip Around running all over the shop. Codesti down the centre, but Iatir is screaming clear with 50 metres to go. And Iatir's going to win it very easily. Iatir first. Second's pretty tight between Whip Around and Codesti wide out. That's a photo. Alexander's Joy disappointed running fourth. They were followed by Chesapeake Warrior, Primo Bay, Credit Wise and Reap the Harvest last in.
And three in a photo for the first at Hawkesbury, Rod Quinn, the winning jockey, and he's in pretty good form. Kieran, that was...
Fire.
Yeah, but again, Brendan, I can only reiterate, you can't back every horse in the race, and she represents, in my opinion, respectable value. I've put in number six, Spice Doll. It's around third now. There is value, $31 on the tote, but it ran second. Sorry, third to
Flavour in the Spring Stakes.
In the Spring Stakes, at weight for age, carries 55 and a half now. Has Flavour got some chance in the Eatwell? Now, drawn inside, at his best, is a genuine chance. So you would have to concede the fact that she could have a nice run and be some sort of chance at what I consider ridiculous value.
OK, awaiting a scales report at Gawler, those two lates.
So they're all in, set to run. Ready to go, light flashing, 1200 the journey. All clear. And away, Pernod and Miss Power Bird both began well, drawn alongside one another. Dynamic Love got away okay towards the inside, but Poppet began very fast and crosses them to lead. As they put the first 200 behind them, it's Poppet from Miss Power Bird. Spy stole the outside. Pont on Fly moving up fourth on the outside of these, and then Pernod. Dynamic Love, she's followed by Rain Dance Lady. A length and a half further back is Susie Gray, being followed by Purple Groove, Pace Invader out wide. And then came Rose Beach, Shattered Love and Diltrice. Hitting to the 600, Poppet narrowly. From Spice Doll, two lengths away in the field. Pot on Flyer outside, Miss Power Bird. A length to Pernod, fifth outside, Dynamic Love. Then came Purple Groove, Rain Dance Lady the outside and Susie Gray. From Shattered Love, Pace Invader, Rose Beach and Diltrice as they cornered. Poppet on the inside in front of Spice Doll. On their outside, Pont on Fly. There's the run for Miss Power Bird. She's coming with her burst, and down the outside comes Pernod. They got to the 200. Miss Power Bird sprinted quickly from Pont on Fly. Perno's under the whip. Dynamic Love is coming with a run. Miss Power Bird in front. Dynamic Love, Purple Groove and Pernod chaser. Miss Power Bird clear, though. Miss Power Bird takes it out. Purple Groove and Dynamic Love and a photo finish for the Miners, and Pernod tastes defeat for the first time fourth. Then came Pot on Flyer. Rosebeat made a little ground. From Shattered Love, Susie Gray, Poppet tired. Back behind them then, Rain Dance Lady. Spice Doll dropped out of it. Pace Invader next to last, and Deltrice last all the way. Miss Powerbird, Greg Childs, had the Casey run behind the speed and sprinted brilliantly when she got into the clear in the early part of the straight, and then held out three or four of them for a strong win in the Dairy Farmers Milk Stakes. Number 10, Miss Powerbird, Greg Childs is the winner, trained by Leon Corstens. Photo finish for the minor end of the prize. 10 and a photo after race number two. She was too good. Purple Groove has made plenty of ground on the outside, and Dynamic Love's got through on the inside as Pernod struggled in the last 150 and Pont on Flyer dropped out after racing handy. And here are the minors coming up now. Number 11 has got second. Purple Groove, written by Nash Rabutta's, run second. And Dynamic Love, written by Brett Preble, fills third place. Numbers in the second event are 10, 11 and 2.
And number 14 in fourth, Greg Childs, who saddles up. And we're talking through his book of rides. We got him one race late, didn't we? Go get her $1.80.
Not really, Brendan.
Poem, exactly. You were spot on with the mail there and how the race would pan out. Poem's now out to 7.650 with 7.80 and firming for Timidity, number five, as we head trackside to Hawkesbury for race two. Terry Bailey is your caller.
High Society Girl's got a great chance in the race number six. I've given her a real good chance of running a drum. She's at the $10.30 mark. Go get a 180-130. Ebony Clare given a rough chance, $18. Poem, number four, consistent, 631.90. Timidity, there's been a little bit of money for it, $8.250. High Society Girl, $8.50, $1.80. And that's where the buck stops. These open gates, they look magnificent, don't they, as the runners come up into line. Here is Palace Engagement, Matt Privado. Matt hasn't been back all that long after a long absence after that Ipswich Cup drama. And he's been riding in terrific heart, booting home winners left, right and centre. In fact, at most of the meetings he's been at. Now, Magic of Rosie, who was run down at Cessnock the other day, coming up, speed to burn out of the gate. Palace Engagement standing well, so too is Red Legacy. Go Getter has the white, pale blue and dark blue sleeves. Dark blue and white striped cap. And the light is flashing. Set to jump. Ebony Clear just moving about. Catrella and also Reassured wide out on the move with Timidy and Stratism. They're off. Magic of Rosie, Palace Engagement, Stratism wide out and Reassured away quickly. Poem showing speed, Ebony Clear and Go Getter bustling up on the fence. High Society Girl just behind those settling down. They were followed by Timidy the Grey over Catrella, Red Legacy and River in Red last of all. Magic of Rosie, three wide, Go Getter on the fence, Ebony Clear in the centre. Two lengths away, fourth is Palms, very wide out then is Reassured from Timidy the Grey, High Society Girl, the rail from Palace Engagement. They were followed by Catrella, Stratism drop well back from River in Red and last of all, Red Legacy. Magic of Rosie in full flight on the final bend, leading by two lengths on Go Getter, shaken up the fence to give chase. They've got away from High Society Girl, peeling off their backs and down the centre, Timidy. The leader is Magic of Rosie. Timidy's the danger from Go Getter, High Society Girl, Palm running on reasonably. Timidy's moved up to Magic of Rosie in the grey, sprinted to the front. Timidy opening up with 50 metres to go, and Timidy's careering away to win it by three lengths to Magic of Rosie and Go Getter. Behind those, High Society Girl fourth. They were followed next of all by Palm wide out on the track. Just in behind those, pulling up quickly, was Catrella with Palace Engagement Reassured. They were followed by Stratism, Ebony Clear, second last on the fence, River in Red, and last of all, Red Legacy.
Timidity, Bernadette Cooper, 8.49.37.80, beating Magic of Rosie, Go Getter, the favourite, in third position. 5.11.1, Quinella's trifecta's winning time to be confirmed. Updating.
The inside gate probably is no spoil for her, but she is certainly the best tried in the race. Milagramis, La Lagoon, and then True Jewels. They're nearly ready. Here's La Lagoon coming up into the line. Kieran McAvoy on board, and Lilo Lil, who got knocked out of the beginning of the Ascot Vale last start, took the outside gate, so the field is now set. All clear. They're away. Muga Chakra a touch slow down on the inside. Ashkelita first out with Haste Back and Vickers. Away quickly, Milagramis and the orange colours settling fourth, but pace from her outside with Tally Thunder shooting up fast from True Jewels. Lilo Lil's going forward as well. Settling fully now near the 1,000 metres. Tally Thunder from Ashkelita, Lilo Lil up to third. A length Haste Back now fourth, and then came True Jewels fifth the outside. Just wants to over race a touch there. A length and a half to Vickers, Milagramis and Uga Chark at the rail. They're followed by Pella Darmar and La Lagoon on the outside. A length and a half further back is Hot Beat for Angelica and Shark Elmer in the centre. Another length and a half then Special Grange 1. Moen Dragila is two lengths away last of all. Up the side nearing the 600, Lilo Lil, who jumped from the outside gate, is up on the outside of Tally Thunder. True Jewels three deep and third, followed then by Ashkelita over on the inside from Haste Back and Milagramis. A length to Uga Chaka as they neared the corner, followed by La Lagoon. Juanmo starts a run round the outside, and they were followed as they cornered then by Frangelica. Into the straight now, Tally Thunder from Lilo Lil, True Jewels. Ascalita can get a rails run and so can Haste You Back. Wider out, Milagramis is coming with a run, and Vickers is putting in with Uga Chaka looking for a run clear. True Jewels, Haste You Back, 150 to go. Haste You Back takes the lead on the inside. Milagramis chases her, but Haste You Back is clear, comes away. Haste You Back brilliantly on the line from Milagramis, and Special Grange flew home, might have grabbed third. Hot Beats there over on the inside and a photo with her from Vickers, Uga Chaka, True Jewels. Then La Lagoon, Dragila, followed by Sharel Malilo Lil. Back behind them, Tally Thunder and Frangelica. And they were followed by Juan Mo Ascalita dropping out on the inside, and Peladama, one of the last to greet the judge. Leon Corstens has taken out the Quinella and a running double. Number 8, the winner, Haste You Back to pay 18.20 and 4.80, Brett Preble. Haste You Back, the winner. Second place in going to the more favoured stablemate, Milagramis, number 2. And third, number 14 has got it, Special Grange turning in a big finish down the outside. So placings in the TBV Trackball Star Stakes are 8, 2 and 14. 8.
Let's go trackside.
Okay, Andrew, thank you. And Les joining us. Wim Wham is the favourite. Whatever he does, he's going to improve in the mounting yard. From his looks in the yard as he paraded, he's got a big tummy on him. But he's been well tried. He got out to pretty good odds, nearly half each way there, or half the each way quote. He's just come back in again. 290 on the tote, you're doing a lot better. 290 was never bet on track. It's always been a bit shorter than that. Champagne Crazy paraded really well in the yard as they come forward. Champagne Crazy looked great in the yard. Brand New paraded pretty well as well. Now the last few come up. This is over 1,200 metres. It's quite odd calling when you're used to the barrier structure that we've had for so many years. Is Madam Governor moving in? 1,200 metres. Wim Wham the favourite, the Cerise Jacket. He's into $2.80. You're doing real well on the tote in New South Wales with the $2.80 in comparison. Set to go. All ready. And they're racing. Broken a very good line. Madam Governor duped again and also dropping back Mr. Desperado after the start. Winsome Gold and E-Horse began well. E-Horse will lead Winsome Gold. Brand Power third, Champagne Crazy outside of it, a length to Algernon. Alzamora four wide, Wim Wham deep from Madam Governor, the grey duped again the fence. Favourite's been pushed back to third last, three or four Jarcy Girl, and a further two and a half away, Mr. Desperado. Speeds right on coming off the back. And the leader is E-Horse by three quarters on Winsome Gull. Three links to Brand Power, two links Champagne Crazy. Algernon around duped again, wide out Alzamora. Then came Madam Governor. They were followed by Wim Wham. Eight links off the lead and in traffic. Three links Jarcy Girl and two links Mr. Desperado. E-Horse has set a blinding speed coming to the bend at the 350 by two links on Brand Power getting into the clear. Winsome Gull went very wide rounding the bend. Then came duped again. Wim Wham's well back in the straight at the 200. E-Horse in front. Brand Power's looming up. They were followed by duped again running on from Wim Wham getting a gap in the centre. Brand Power's moved up to E-Horse. Wim Wham screaming through. Wim Wham's got Brand Power. Wim Wham hit the lead from Brand Power and Wim Wham, big win. Wim Wham's beaten Brand Power. Third, very tight, E-Horse or Jarcy Girl from duped again. Madam Governor behind those. Then Champagne Crazy, Algernon, Alzamora, well back, Mr. Desperado and the erratic Winsome Gull last in. Well, that's been a big win. He looked to be in real trouble coming to the bend. In fact, didn't look like he could win. But once into the clear, he has produced a barnstorming finishing burst. Number two at $2.50, starting a bit shorter on track. And Wim Wham has raced home to win it well. Brand Power will run second. Horse number four, Shane Treweek. And E-Horse may have just lasted for third in front of either Jarcy Girl or Duped again, and looks to have done so, looking at our replay ridden by Danny Beasley. Numbers are 2, 4 and 7 are confirmed. 2, 4 and 7, the time is...
Got gate speed, and I don't think that holds him in good stead. No, I'm fairly happy and fairly content with 2, 1, 3 and 6.
OK, that's the way the betting looks, and that's the latest news we have from here as we head up to the race calling tower. Greg Miles to call them in.
Links in now, North Boy is set. The Guineas Prelude coming up, Brendan. North Boy, can he maintain an unbeaten run? He comes to Caulfield for the first time. His win's coming at the other three metropolitan tracks so far. But he did win with plenty in the tank in the Ascot Vale, coming down the better section of the track, admittedly, but he meets most of his rivals here at the same weights or even a touch better. Now, Ustinov has moved in out of the great mare Letzalope. Probably clearly the best that she's produced so far. Yes, I will, over the moon, the other two that we've seen race here. There's Neewand going up into the line. Pace in the race, probably from the likes of Tally Dane and North Boy. Wider out, Pure Theatre, the Concert Grand. Go. All clear and they're racing. Tally Dane jumped okay. Ebony Knight slow. North Boy pinged out brilliantly. Away quickly, Counter Agent and King of Prussia. The Concert Grand on the improve, wider out with Participate. At the 1,100 metres, North Boy goes forward and leads them. It's North Boy in front of Participate outside the Concert Grand, settling second and third. Tally Dane is fourth, King of Prussia fifth. Back behind those horses then is Classic Cutover on the outside from Craig of Adder. on the inside then is Counter Agent, a break of about four lengths behind these to Niwon Spectatorial. Euston off a long way back, and so is Pure Theatre, Ebony Knight, and Zonctus last of all by the 800. And North Boy tries to do it all, and the Guineas Prelude out by a little over two lengths. Participators second, the Concert Grand third, the inside, King of Prussia fourth, Classic Cut around it, Tully Dane the rail. Another two lengths to over on the inside as Counter Agent as they neared the corner. And they were being followed by Craig of Ad, a break to Spectatorial, Niwon, Pure Theatre, Ustinov, Zonked, and Ebony Knight. North Boy came to the turn in front. King of Prussia's the first to throw out a challenge as they come around the home turn, and they're clear of Classic Cut. Back behind them, Pure Theatre getting to the outside. North Boy under serious threat at the 200. The odds-on favourite has been headed by King of Prussia, and running on is Pure Theatre. It's King of Prussia with Pure Theatre chasing him, and then North Boy. Pure Theatre's raced up. He's the real McCoy. Pure Theatre comes away and wins it well from King of Prussia, North Boy. And back behind those then was Classic Cut making good ground, and then came Ebony Knight, trailed further back by Ustinov, and then came Counter Agent Niwond. Behind these is Zonked, followed by the Concert Grand, Craig of Ad, Spectatorial, and back last in the race is Participate. Pure Theatre, the bar keeps getting raised. He keeps getting better. $30.80 and $6, but he did it in the manner that there was no fluke about it. Second King of Prussia, third North Boy, out to the 1400, but he got to the 200 metre mark and he ran out of gas. King of Prussia claimed him, looked the winner, but Pure Theatre came with a wondrous burst and has won brilliantly for Darren Biedman and Robert Priscott. Number 12, Pure Theatre, the winner of the Guineas Prelude. Number 6, second, King of Prussia, Brett Prebble. And number 2, third, North Boy, ridden by Damien Oliver. It seemed he didn't run the trip, the favourite, because he really, although he did a little work to find the front in the early stages, he was left alone pretty much, and he didn't find once he was joined near the 200 metre mark. He's run third, but a touch on the disappointing side, looking more a sprinter than a horse who's going to get out to the Guineas distance and what he did there. 12.62, fourth home was number 5, Classic Cut, and fifth was number 3, Tully Dane. But I think this bloke is the one that is going to be the Guineas type of horse on what he did there. Robert Priscott prepared. He's had the one run here in Australia after winning his maiden on wet ground in New Zealand. And he did look the genuine article, although in weaker company, big step in grade. And he answered the challenge today in great style. 12.62 it was in the Carlton Draft Guineas Prelude.
Well, we heard from Robert Priscott pre-race, and he gave it a nice chance, the Nureyev three-year-old, but he snuck under the guard of plenty of punters at those quotes. The Quinella 248.50 is what it's returned. 12 and 6, 2 third. If you're wondering what ran fourth, it was the Perth horse, Classic Cut, thereby emphasising Alf's reference to the Karrakatta plate form. Sunshine Coast, they're getting close. Ratings to a special. Have a Say, now into $2.10. And Have a Say has been the one which has been well tried here. Merv Lewis trained Scott Galloway with the ride. Second Ipswich, its most recent start. This is a 2,200 metre race. They're set.